quite sure if you guys got the energy left or not, you know?
Soft intro. Let's fucking go. I've never heard an intro like this on a Smashing Pumpkins song. Waiting for a really big just crash in. There we go. Come on, baby. Come on. Oh my God. I want to hear this as the world is ending. Slow motion.
I'm not afraid to
Oh my God, the tone is so delicious. Dude, fucking right, dude. So right off the bat, let me state that like Smashing Pumpkins are one of my all-time favorite bands. And it's one of those bands where I can't say I know the whole discography. I can, you know, I could shit out 30 songs that I know, you know, all the hits, all of some handful of popular deep cuts. But I can't, you know, from what I know, this is a very popular song amongst fans. And I swear to God, I haven't heard this yet. But recently, I saw this guy on TikTok named Jacob Givens. He's a comedian and super into this 90s music era, especially Smashing Pumpkins. And he kind of landed on my For You page, kind of totally raving about mayonnaise and all the other fans as well. What a troll name of a song title. Like, it's so funny to make like a vibe out masterpiece and just slap that kind of title on it. It's like indie absurdness before indie absurdness was a thing. Like, oh, my band's name is Retro Helicopter Attack Panda. Like, like just randomness. That lol intro is fucking amazing. It sounds so warm and like, I don't know, it sounds like one of those direct taping. Like, it doesn't sound fucked with a computer. Like, it's, oh my God, it sounds like you're right there in a room with a guy plugged into an amp. And I love this type of dynamic where we have I love that 90s aesthetic, especially. I think that's like a big stereotype of these big 90s vibe anthems, is like these lull intros that lead to something really fucking heavy and grungy. My favorite song of all time, Hero of the Day, Metallica, is this lullaby intro that goes into really the only song on the album that has this kind of double bass pedal kick in the midsection of the song. You know, Drown by Smashing Pumpkins is my all-time favorite Pumpkins song. Has this lully intro, kind of like Today, and leads into just heaviness. Dude, Smashing Pumpkins are like the distortion fuzz kings. I work with a guy who's a uber Pumpkins fan, and he said he loves the guitar sound fuzz on Siamese Dream more than any other album. I wonder if that rig is iconic, if there was a particular guitar used during that recording. But it does seem pretty signature Smashing Pumpkins to have that buzz fuzz kind of loud distortion, but mixed really well feel to it. Let me get into the lyrics here, because it was such a vibe and it's so loud and slow motion, but I couldn't really get what was being said. And I rarely look up lyrics, but I don't want these reactions to be half-assed and kind of like, let me sit through a song, throw out five different fucking things I picked up on it, and then like not really elaborate anything. Let's see here. Fool enough to almost be it, cool enough to not quite see it. Doomed, pick your pockets full of sorrow and run away with me tomorrow. June. We'll try and ease the pain, but somehow we'll feel the same. Well, no one knows where our secrets go. I send a heart to all my dearies when your life is so, so dreary. Dream, I'm rumored to the straight and narrow while the harlots of my perils scream. And I fall, but when I can, I will try to understand that when I can, I will. Mother weep the years I'm missing, all our time can't be given back. Shut my mouth and strike the demons that cursed you and your reasons. Out of hand and out of season, out of love and out of feeling, so bad. When I can, I will, words defy the plan, when I can, I will. Fool enough to almost be it, and cool enough to not quite see it, and old enough to always feel this, always old, I'll always feel this. No more promise, no more sorrow, no longer will I follow. Can anybody hear me? I just want to be me. When I can, I will. Try to understand than when I that when I can, I will. Wow. Really playful rhyme scheme there, you know, kind of childlike and Dr. Seuss-esque, but I'm sensing some sort of story about finding love with someone new, kind of trying to recapture maybe what wasn't fully captured or embraced in the youth when he was going through youth. Maybe this feeling of like trying to be yourself, trying to find happiness, trying to find real love, and you're realizing that so much time has already passed and you'll never ever get to backtrack into those days that have already passed. And all you can really do now is embrace, you know, who you are now. You know, if you didn't get to be who you wanted to be then, all you have now is to be that person now. And he's talking about maybe trying to find it with this new person or someone who's along this life journey with him, maybe just a friend, not even romantically, you know, talking about his mother, weep the years I'm missing, all our time can't be given back. Maybe speaking to his mother about maybe interactions with her in the past or how he may have come across in the past. This is very like looking back, kind of reflecting while kind of running through the wheat field into a sunset and like finally embracing you and himself, even if it might seem a little too late, which is really, really heavy, man. Cause I think about that all the time. I spend so much time occupied on the past and what I would have done differently. And I wish I would have embraced who I was back then or been this content back then and stuff. But it's like, fuck, you're still alive. You're still in it. You're in the game. You're here right now. And then it's called Mayonnaise, dude. What the, that's fucking awesome. I love this song. This, I know it's first listen and I got the hype going on, but this is up there in the top favorites now. This is going in so many playlists, man. Let me know the first time you heard this song. I've noticed a lot of comments on this channel have been super personal. Like, hey, I listened to this album when I was on the college steps in 19, blah, blah, blah. Or I was going through this life event when I heard this, or this helped me get through this. I fucking love that shit. I live for those type of comments. I think it's crazy that I'm getting interactions with people in their lives more than just, hey, this video was cool, or hey, like the video, or hey, cool reaction. Give me the in-depth stuff. I want to read your paragraphs. Thank you so much for watching. If you feel so inclined, subscribe, comment. This channel is a way of venting all of my creative endeavors that I do currently and plan to down the road. This is just kind of a kind of blur of everything I want to create and listen to and all that shit. So thank you so much for being here, for supporting me, for watching. Take care of yourselves. I will see you in the next one.